Now we are going to discuss the data structure queue. Queue is actually, you know, as this is a simple queue, and this is a queue of cars, and this is the first vehicle, and it will be served first, and this is the last vehicle, it will be served in last. So queue has very simple rule, and the rule is first in, first out, last in, last out. Otherwise, on the other hand, as we had have discussed stack earlier, stack has the opposite rule. It says the last in will be first out. Like you can see the example here, the last ball pushed was this one, and when we will try to pop, this will be popped first. On the other hand, this is a queue of persons, and this person will be served first because it came first, and this person will be served at last because it came in the last. So this is a queue, and we can implement this queue using an array data structure. So in array data structure, in while implementing a stack, we had only one index because the pushing and popping was on one end only, whereas in case of queue we use both ends. At one end we dequeue the elements, and on at other end we enqueue the elements. So here we will use two indexes. One will be managed in the rear end, and other will be managed in the front end. So here is an array. Here at start, front is here because 5 came first, then came 4, then came 6, then came 7, then came 8, then came 7, and then came 6, and rear pointer, a rear index will be here. So whenever a new entry will come, we will increment the rear index. So like if 12 comes and 67 comes, rear will reach here. And whenever these entries are dequeued, I mean they are served, the front pointer will move forward. When 5 is dequeued, F will come here. When 4 will be dequeued, F will come here. And finally, when all these are dequeued, F pointer will come here. So we will increment front pointer when the elements are served or dequeued, and we will increment the rear pointer when new elements or new entries are added. So here is a problem. The problem is, at this time we have these free spaces, but our rear index is at the last index of the array. So this gives a message that array is full. So at this point we are actually wasting the memory. So what is the solution of this problem? One solution is we can drag all these values to the left, and so that we have some space at the end. But this is a costly solution because in this scenario we have to use more instructions, and it is a costly in terms of computations. Another smart solution may be that whenever there is a space in the array or in the other words, when the queue is not full, we can add further entries in these cells. So when r will reach here at index 8, the r plus plus will give us 0, so we will reach here. So if new entry comes, so we will enter it here. Suppose nice come, then here, so r here, then r here, so this way r will reach here. So this is called the concept of circular queue. Like you can see it here, front is here, back is here, back is moving on forward. Now A was served, B was served, so front is moving as well. So at this point we will move in the start. So this is called circular queue, and by using circular queue we can efficiently use the memory of the array. So now how to move the back pointer to the start from the end of the array? We can use this if condition. When the rear pointer reaches at the end of the array, we will make it 0. otherwise we will keep it incrementing. And this four lines of code can be summed up in this one line of code, which says whenever we increment the rear pointer, we take its mod with q size. So if rear is, suppose the q size is 5, so when rear value is 0, then 0 plus 1 will be 1, 1 mod 5 will be 1, and similarly 2 mod 5 will be 2. But when the rear value is at the last of the array size, say it is 4, so at 4 the adding 1 will make it 5, and 5 mod 5 will give us 0. So we will go to the start of the array. So this if condition can be easily summed up by this one statement. So this is the queue, and so in the next lecture we do programming for it in C++. So stay tuned.